Michael.
Okay.
Well, hey. All right, here we go again. You know, this, Mike, you just came in. This customer here, Mike. Yeah, thanks for coming in. We got Brad Schoenborn here, and I was just kind of walking around helping other customers and just being here, and I realized that Brad was helping Mike set up this really cool diver and bait setup that I thought I'd share with all of you. So, but first of all, you showed him how to tie an egg loop, right?
Right.
Yeah. So he's got, you know, the double rig egg loop that Brad went ahead and just showed him step by step, you know, how to do this. So what you need to do, if you have questions like this, you want to learn things like this, you need to get in here while Brad's in here, which is Saturday 10 to 2, and he can work with you like that. I mean, it's like you there's no other place in the world you can get help like that.
Yeah, it was awesome. He taught me 4 things that I had never done before.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's kind of a neat thing. You really should take advantage of coming in here and spending some time. But, all right, now, Brad, why don't you go through and explain what you set up for him here and where he's going to fish this.
We can set up
for
another
one. He's in the Clackamas River in Oregon, and this is a standard diver from Brad's. Dives about 7 to 10 feet down, depending upon the current. And you're actually back trolling this with, I'm using 15-pound test P-line. And it's fluorocarbon coated so the fish won't see it. For number 6 Spin N Glo body, I use 2 beads on purpose so that the tail of the shrimp will get caught on the Spin N Glo.
Okay.
And then you got a double hook rig so you can lay your shrimp or your prawn out straight.
Right. Yeah, so you didn't put a wire on there. Would you ever put the wires on like you did?
I would for sure if I was just prawns, but for shrimp, I don't need it.
Okay, so you're putting sand shrimp on there. Yeah. So that's what I mean, that he's got these, Brad's has these little wires all pre-twisted.
Yeah.
And as a prawn straightener. So if you're going to use a coon shrimp on there, you could include that in the rig.
It works great, too.
Yeah.
It's lifesaver.
And we have some spinners in here that Brad tied up that are all ready to go like that. But yeah, so diver and bait with a Spin N Glo. I like it.
Well, come to me, guys. I'm happy to work with you.
Yeah, all right. Hey, and please subscribe to the YouTube channel. We'll get a lot more videos like this and more instructional things like this. And it would really help us out if you could support us by subscribing to the YouTube channel. You know, we got TV viewers all over the North America. You know, that's really awesome. But these days we need the help from the internet, you know. So if you could subscribe to the YouTube channel, we'd sure appreciate it. So thanks a lot, Brad. Thanks for coming in, Mike. Hope you catch some fish. You're going to send us some pictures, right?
Yeah, thank you for all the information.
All right on.
Yeah, when I catch fish, I'll send you some pictures.
Awesome.
Mike, I should show you this.
Yeah.
I put this between the beads, like this. Mm-hmm. The beads.
You just put it in between the beads.
Yep. And then you take a coon shrimp.
Yeah.
They come really tight. Mm-hmm. I put a big one, right, in that small, and then just put the tail first with that wire. Right beside there.
Mm-hmm.
That wire holds on.
Uh-huh.
Then I just hook the hooks real light into the prawn. The coon shrimp, and just back to that, it works great.
Oh, I see, yeah.
You need that for a shrimp or standard.
So the prawn would hang down here, and then you'd put the bottom of the hook up into the shrimp.
This is your shrimp here.
The prawn.
This is your shrimp here, your prawn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, and we got the spinners set up. They've got the Washington coon shrimp. That's what they're talking about over here. We got in stock, you know, the coon shrimp or a sand shrimp. That's different. But for the coon shrimp, that wire is really a good way to go.
Oh, for coon shrimp. Yeah. I see.
And since they're so soft, it doesn't really stay on that. It's firm.
And once it was on, it would go. It would just hold it on to this?
Right. Yes.
Oh, okay. And keep it straight. I see. But it would be in between these two beads?
Yes.
Okay.
Would you ever use thread on that, or does that hold it good enough like that?
Good enough, unless you're fishing fast water.
Yeah. Yeah. So the ghost thread's another thing, too, like saying maybe not such fast water, you might not need it, but if you're having trouble with the bait coming off, no harm in putting a little thread on there, and we've got the little ghost thread. Spools up here by. I'll show it to you real quick. Right here, we got a bunch right by the register. So this is really good stuff and tie that on. Anyway, hope to see you guys in here and hope we can help you out and catch more fish.
Okay, and would you put coon shrimp on these hooks also?
Yes.
Okay.
Just one shrimp, is that straight?
Mm-hmm. Okay.